at this show, as at the Gray Zone, I can't think of another outlet that considers himself on the left that has been giving a critique of the big pharma and government's rollout of their COVID policies. And everybody's afraid to do that because the Democratic Party is now a cult. And if you, as was shown by Trevor Noah and Sarah Silverperson most recently, if you go even one inch outside the approved narrative, you are kicked out of the cult and called a racist and an anti-vaxxer like that. Okay? So here, I just want to show you this. I saw this was tweeted out by Brittle Star. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but or whatever this guy is. But I'm going to tell you who he is in a second. But watch this. This is going to be surprising to you, I think.
I've just had my third shot. A booster, they call it. How many more are they going to make us get? Don't know, don't care. Because I, like you probably, understand there is a global pandemic, and people much, much smarter than you and me have decided this is the best plan of action to avoid lots more people dying or cluttering up hospital hallways. You and I, we're doing our part by getting one more little prick and not being one. I've just.
Okay, so that is a scientific argument. But you want to, can we play it again and I'll stop?
I've just had my third shot. A booster, they call it. How many more are they going to make us get? Don't know, don't care.
Wow. Don't know. You don't get much more scientific than that, do you? Don't know, don't care. I think that should be the new Hippocratic Oath. Don't know, don't care. The only argument more scientific than don't know, don't care is God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. And that's as true as when Einstein first tweeted it. Am I right? Come on.
Honestly, like, I don't know what comedians are dealing with, but the musicians, I actually probably am around more comedians these days than I used to be, thanks to you. But the musicians I talked to they've taken it, like the ones who perform live, they took a serious hit under lockdown and with all the restrictions and all the fears and, you know, music is coming back. But many of them feel like there's an attack on live music. And I wonder if comedians feel the same. What this guy is doing is basically arguing for endless Zoom comedy and just turning off our critical faculties, which is the essence of comedy, is just like looking at the establishment with total
It's
contempt.
the essence of comedy is to be an anti-establishment person, to poke holes in the authoritarians or the authority. That's the whole thing. So when you're using comedy to promote the status quo, I don't know what that's not comedy. I don't know what that is. I think that's called propaganda. Because comedy actually pushes back against. I mean, it certainly doesn't shame critical thinking. Stop thinking for yourself. What are you going to do? Your own research? You know who does their own research? Dummies. That's who does their own research. I mean, that's what they're saying. That I literally heard comedians go on stage, Max. Can you keep Max here? I literally hear comedians go on stage at comedy clubs in Los Angeles and say things like, "Oh, you're going to do your own research? Oh, you're a genius." That what? So could you be any more anti-intellectual while pretending you're not? Like your acts, that's the irony of that.
Well,
So go ahead.
it's just like journalism.